flawed.
So you both agree there should never have been a special counsel in the first place?
Right.
And yet we have the special counsel. And you both saw him testify the other day. Attorney General Meese, were you concerned by his testimony?
I was concerned by his testimony. I was concerned by the fact that so much of the report seemed to be foreign to him, or at least he was not familiar with it. And I've since reflected the views of a lot of people who were watching, and that was that because he was not familiar with the report because it looked like someone else had written it. And indeed, much of the report itself suffered, in my opinion, a number of flaws as well. The whole idea of laying out what you might call a prosecutor's brief, not an evidentiary brief, but a prosecutor's brief of reasons why someone should have been accused of doing something wrong, and yet very short on evidence, very short on facts, and certainly much too long, particularly in what they called Volume 2, which was directly contrary, actually, to what the law actually says in terms of what obstruction of justice really is. This isn't bribing of witnesses. This isn't destroying documents. This isn't the normal thing you would think about when you talk about obstruction of justice. And that's why I felt that the whole idea of that much material of allegations really without facts made this a flawed report.
Now, the report itself really wasn't supposed to be 500 pages, was it? And turned over to an attorney general, already testified that he was going to give it to Congress, and then prosecutor's office knew who won. You know, the Democrats were now in control, and I read both volumes of this report. And Volume 2 reads like the longest op-ed. What do you make of this?
Well, I, of course, agree with everything that Ed Meese said, and I would add that when he refers to it as a prosecutor's brief, it's interestingly a prosecutor's brief for an impeachment, not a prosecutor's brief for an obstruction prosecution.
And obstruction, let's talk about this a second. You touched on this. Obstruction of justice. Every document that the prosecutors wanted, they got. Every witness that the prosecutors wanted, they got, including the president's own White House counsel. 30 hours, he testifies. No assertion of attorney-client privilege, no assertion of executive privilege, no assertion of any privilege. He doesn't deny them one penny in resources. He never interferes with this investigation. He makes public comments, as I think any citizen might if they feel they're innocent. But he never actually takes steps as president of the United States to do anything. And yet, the report and the Democrats focus on McGahn, his White House counsel, who said, and the president denies this, but who said, yeah, the president contacted me about, you know, getting rid of Mueller. Is this obstruction of justice?
Certainly not. As a matter of fact, when you saw some of the things that were happening in the special prosecutor's, special counsel's office at that time, the fact that the overwhelming majority of the lawyers that had been hired were Democrats, many of them not just ordinary voting Democrats, but Democrats who had contributed large amounts of money to the Democrat Party, and particularly to the to Mr. Trump's opponent during the election, those kinds of things. The fact that many other things, the way in which they conducted some of the activities there, including bringing charges in the course of their process to people totally unrelated to anything having to do with Russia or having to do with the president. Some cases that had been many years before, or acts many years before, in which they were, it looked like they were charging people with crimes simply to get them in a position that they could then be bludgeoned into talking and saying something negative about the president. So the whole thing, to me, if I were a president, I would be really appalled that that kind of conduct was being carried out under the Department of Justice that was ultimately responsible to me.